bookmark that site, folks, because YouTube may soon go completely vanilla on you.
It is becoming increasingly obvious that to understand what the world was like in the days of Noah, we need only to listen to True News. For this announcer, these stories and others that we'll be covering on today's broadcast are just signs that the Lord's return is getting closer and closer each day. We are living in the days of reprieve, days of mercy, and days of grace. Mark my words, those days are numbered, my friend. We're told in the scripture that there will be wars and rumors of wars, and we're also told in the last days malice, murder, and mayhem will increase. The True News team of Edward Zolf, Yor Hernandez, and Zach Drew are standing by like watchmen on the wall of the world, ready to offer their updates, insight, and analysis to these stories and more on this Monday edition of True News. I'm your announcer, Doc Burkhart, sitting in for your host, Rick Wiles, who is attending a very important series of meetings today that will determine the future course of this ministry. Thank you for joining us, and I bring in the team. Good afternoon, folks. How are we today?
Doing good. I'll tell you what, like you just got done showing us, there is a lot happening in the world, and it shows us exactly where we are on the prophetic timetable.
Well, we already know about the Chinese troops lining up on the North Korean border, and we've had reports from friends in China, like we played last week, about other military assets, including jets and military armaments moving toward North Korea. But the Russians, a lot of people don't know this, Russia actually borders North Korea as well. Okay, so they have a small portion of their border that actually borders North Korea. And they, now these are unconfirmed reports, so I'll just say that now. These are unconfirmed reports. Russians have not confirmed this, but they are also moving military assets on the North Korean border as well. But in other comments about this, Russia has also warned against Syria-style actions in North Korea. Edward, what do you think about that?
Well, I think Sergey Lavrov, the foreign minister, made that comment. He's making it very clear that Russia is not going to sit by while a nation that borders them is, again, once attacked by the United States or provocations are carried out against them that haven't gone through what Russia considers the legal means, which would be going through the UN or through the Security Council. Specifically, Sergey Lavrov said he warned against any unilateral actions without the permission of the UN Security Council.
Right. And on state TV, they're calling Trump more dangerous than North Korean's Kim. I mean, what do you guys think about that?
I mean, that just it really just displays what Russia really thinks about the United States right now. You know, in that joint press conference about a week ago between Rex Tillerson and Sergey Lavrov of Russia, it was very, very clear from watching. I watched the entire broadcast. It was extremely clear that Russia and the United States don't agree on hardly anything. And actually, Sergey Lavrov even said that. He said, we don't agree on much, if not most, of the issues that we discussed. And it just shows that whenever Putin's state TV said that Trump is more dangerous than North Korea's Kim Jong-un, I mean, it says Russian state television has no doubt who is unpredictable enough to bring the world to war in North Korea crisis, and it's not the reclusive communist dictator Kim Jong-un. According to the Kremlin's top TV mouthpiece, the riskiest is Donald Trump, the man Russian officials and propagandists hailed just a few weeks ago as just the kind of leader the world needed.
Probably got a heads up from probably Russian intelligence or maybe even from Vladimir Putin himself about the whole situation. About the engineered coup that was going on, and where the threat of the nuclear missiles parked at Incirlik Air Base may have been, you know, compromised by Turkish forces. And so this is a big deal, this story that we're covering today, because Erdogan is being set up for the ultimate caliphate in that whole region of the world to kind of be the voice, the face of Islam for the Middle East. A lot of things have to happen in fighting within Islam for that to take place. Am I doing okay on that so far, Edward?
Yeah, you've hit it on the head. I mean, we look at the two countries which could potentially take that mantle. It's Saudi Arabia or the Turkish government.
This is not a political fight. It's not an economic fight. It's not anything like that. Fior, this is a spiritual fight.
It is a spiritual fight, and that's why it always takes me back to saying that the responsibility of the body of Christ is to step in authority. I mean, we have to walk into, in the spirit, we have to walk into the courtrooms of heaven and just pray And just ask that what is written in the books of heaven for this president, our president, Donald J. Trump, and his administration to come to pass. It's not time to sleep. It's not time to rest. It's not time to gossip, certainly. It's time to act in prayer and in authority.
Amen.
And we need to pray with knowledge and understanding.
That's right.
And I just want to let you know that I'm here to basically get you to think.